Welcome you all for Tumbal Online classes. We are discussing the concept of center of mass in the chapter Seismic Particles and Potential Motion. Yesterday we discussed up to the topic of the location of the center of mass by the method of symmetry. And we have seen some applications which are based on that method of symmetry. So today we will discuss the second method. So method of location of center of mass or methods to locate center of mass. The second method we discuss, that method is called as method of decomposition. What is this method of, what we will do, how we will find out the center of mass by the method of decomposition? The given surface will be divided into number of regular parts. We will find out the center of mass of each part. Then we will find out the total mass of the given surface. That is a method of decomposition. To understand this method of decomposition, so let us see one example. We discuss this method of decomposition with one example. So let us suppose one metal plate was plated given like this. So this is the shape of a metal plate given like this. Now I want to calculate the center of mass of this metal surface by using the method of decomposition. So what I am doing is, I am dividing the surface into number of regular parts. So let us see, the regular part I am representing with the dotted line. So this is one. Now I will call this is the part 1. And I will call this is the part 2. And I will call this is the part 3. So this is first step is completed. Divide the surface into number of regular parts. Then so locate the center of mass of each part. So let me call mass per unit area. Here it is made up of, all are made up of same material only. So what is the mass per unit area? That mass per unit area value, so let me call it as sigma. Then I want to calculate what is the mass of the first part. First part mass can I call m1. Second part mass can I call m2, and third part mass can I call m3. So what I will get the answer for m1. So mass per unit area, sigma is nothing but sigma is equal to mass by area, m by area. So what is the mass of the first part? We get m1 is equal to, so sigma into area. What is the area of the first part? So first part area given by length into breadth, so that is 30 into 10, which is given by 300. Can I write 300 into sigma? This one understood na? Sigma is equal to m by e, then m is equal to sigma into e. The first part mass is m1 is equal to 300 into sigma. And what is the mass of the second part? So length value will be given by 20 and breadth value given by 10. So what will get 20 into 10, 200 into sigma. Similarly third part, so third part length value will be given by 10, breadth value also will be given by 10. What is the mass of the third part? Its area value 100 into sigma. Therefore, I calculated the masses of each part. Now, locate the center of mass of each part. So, what is the center of mass of each part? Where does the center of mass of this one? So, this will be there. This is of up to 30 will be there. So, center of mass will be located exactly at 15. Whereas here, it is of, so 10 to 20, 10 is there and 30 is there. So, wherever the center of mass will be located here. And similarly, the center of mass will be located here. Now, finding the coordinates of the center of mass. Let me call the coordinates of center of mass of mass m1 is x1, y1. So what is x1, y1? Values are given by, so this is the center of mass. What is the distance from the x-axis? That is given by 5. What is the distance from the y-axis? That is given by 15. So what are we at? X1, y1 value is equal to 5, 15. Are you getting up? What is x1, y1? The distance of center of, coordinates of center of mass of part 1. Part 1 center of mass is there now. Its total length value 30. Because all are uniform mass distribution. So that's why what happens, center of mass coincide with the geometric center. What is the geometric center here will be of 13. So center will be at a distance of 15. So x coordinate is nothing but distance of the particle from the x axis. Y coordinate nothing but, so distance of the particle from the y, along y axis. So okay now, so this distance value is equal to 5, this distance value is equal to 50. So then similarly, what are the coordinates of center of mass of mass m2 given by x2, y2 value given by. So what about x2, y2 values are given by? So this center of mass distance is given by how much? It is there exactly at the midpoint. Then what will get the coordinates? Here x coordinate value will be given by this length value is equal to how much? So here breadth value is equal to 10. Center of mass will be there exactly at 5. And what about the x coordinate value is equal to? So x coordinate is where does it will coincide? It will coincide exactly at 20. So what will get the x coordinate distance is 20 and y coordinate distance is given by 5. Correct? Understood? So this point. Distance from the x-axis and distance from the y-axis. X-axis distance value is equal to 20 and y-axis distance value will be given by 5. Similarly, what are the coordinates of third point? That is x3 into y3. Third one. So x3, y3, so these coordinates are given. So these coordinates are, this is there up to 20. So what are the coordinates are given by? It is a midpoint in between 10 and 20. The coordinates are given by x coordinate is equal to how much? 50. And what about the y coordinate value is given by? So it is a midpoint between 30 and 20. That is of 25. So that is of 20. Understood? In first step, we divide the given surface into number of regular parts. In the second step, so locating the center of mass of each part. Then finding the total center of mass. Total center of mass is given by the formula. XCM formula is equal to m1 x1 plus m2 into x2 plus m3 into x3 divided by how much m1 plus m2 plus m3. Similarly, what will get formula for ycm? Ycm is equal to m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 divided by how much? Divided by so m1 plus m2 plus m3. By using this formula, if you substitute the values of m1, m2, m3, x1, x2, x3, y1, y2, y3, then we will get the answer of XCM and YCM. Understood now? So this is how to calculate, locate the center of mass by the method of which one? By the method of decomposition. So okay, for example, one more example. They given one T-shaped metal ball. One metal ball is given. So this is one given and here it is one given. Then what to do? So it divided into two parts. This is the first part, this is the second part. Locating the center of mass of this part and this part. Then finding the total center of mass. So this is called as method of decomposition. After completion of the method of decomposition, so next third method is method of integration. Which one? Third method is given by method of integration. So this method is applicable for uniform mass distribution. Whenever they given a rod of uniform mass, how to locate the center of mass? Yesterday we discussed how to locate the center of mass for discrete mass distribution and how to locate the center of mass for continuous mass distribution. So whenever the distribution of mass is continuous, then what we need to do is, so we will divide the given body into number of elements. Consider one such element of mass d. So let us consider one fixed point O. So what is the distance of this element from the fixed point? So that one let me call x. Then how can I find out XCM is given by? XCM is equal to integration. Yesterday written x into dm divided by, so integration of dm. Integration of dm is nothing but m. So this is the formula to calculate XCM. For which body is continuous mass distribution? By using which method? Method of integration. Here we are using integration. Understood now? To understand this method still properly, so let me see one example. So let us consider one solid cone of, so height value h and base radius value is equal to r. Okay now? Height value is equal to h value and radius of the base value is equal to r. So what I want to find out, what is the location of the center of mass from the vertex? So this is the vertex. From the vertex, what is the location of the center of mass? This height value is equal to how much? So this is equal to h. This is of uniform mass distribution. Okay now? For this, so uniform cone, solid cone of base radius r, height h, what is the distance of the center of mass from the vertex? So calculate the center of mass. So let us divide into number of parts. Let me consider one element. So that circular element, that element of our circular disk of radius value r, that disk of thickness value dx. What about this thickness of the, this value will be given by dx, which is at a distance x from the vertex. Understood? What I consider? I consider one element, that element of radius value r, that element of thickness value dx. What is the mass of this element is given by mass, circular cross section. So mass value is equal to pi into r square into. So what I will get the answer will be given by pi r square into dx, area into length, into rho. Can I write down? Where rho is the density. Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass is equal to density into volume. So what is the volume of that element is given by pi r square into dx. This is the mass one. The next one is, so applying the similar triangle properties. From the similar triangle properties, what can I able to write it? So if I consider that this triangle, in this triangle, so what about this value is equal to x, and in this triangle if I consider, so this value will be equal to x. By considering the similar triangles, if I call OE, this value of B, and this value of C, and this value of B. From the similar triangle properties, what can I write is r divided by capital R. R is the radius of this element. So capital R is the radius of this base of this element, will be equal to x divided by opposite side. So ratio of the opposite sides will be equal to the ratio of adjacent side. R divided by R is equal to x by h. Then what will get R value? Because for these both theta value will be same. So R value is equal to R into x divided by h. Understood? Now how can I calculate the center of mass by the method of integration? XCM is given by integration of x into dA. So here limits are what? This element. This element maximum distance value 0, minimum distance value 0, maximum distance value h, 0 to h, x into dm by integration of 0 to h dm. So let me substitute the values of dm value. So when I substitute the dm value, what I will get? Integration of x into dm value, pi into r square into dx into rho. Integration limits are 0 to h by, so denominator what I will get, 0 to l, dm value pi into r square into dx into rho. Okay, now we need to simplify this integration. So tell me what we will get. And this is, so xcm value is equal to, can I substitute the r value? R is equal to r into x divided by h. Then what I will get, integration of 0 to h. So that is x into pi into r square value 1 by r square into x square divided by h square. Correct? Into dx into rho. Divided by denominator also, can I substitute? So 0 to h into, so denominator value 1 by pi into r square value, capital R square into x square divided by h square into dx into rho. So which term I can bring outside the integration? Pi into, so capital R square into rho divided by which one now? H square, can I bring outside? So within the integration 0 to h, so here what I will get? X cube into dx divided by denominator, what I will get? So denominator also I can take the common, pi into R square into rho by h square. Then within the integration, so what is left is given by x square into dx. Understood now? So this term will be cancelled. Now, what is integration of x power n formula? Integration of x power n formula will be given by, so here what we get, which is equal to x power 4 by 4, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Limits are given by 0 to h. Denominator of integration of x square value, x power 3 by 3. So integration limits are given by 0 to h. Are you getting what is the formula here we are using? Since integration of x power n formula, integration of x power n into dx is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Okay, then I will get this. So after simplification, substitute the limits. upper limit minus lower limit. After total simplification, so h same value will be given by, so 3 into h divided by 4. What does it mean is, in case of the cone of uniform cone, the center mass will be located at a distance of here, center mass will be there somewhere. So what is the distance of the center mass from the vertex? So that value will be equal to 3h by 4. It is not coincident with the geometric center. So there 3h by 4. Are you getting now? This is what is the method we applied. So that is called as method of integration. Okay? If it is a hollow cone, so the value will be given by 2h by 3. So what is the distance of the center of mass from the vertex of a hollow cone? So that value will be given by 2h into h divided by 3. Okay? So these are the methods to locate the center of mass. After completion of the methods to locate the center of mass, now you will see, yesterday we discussed it because of adding, what is the distance of center of mass from the combination. So today we will discuss regarding the removing. Because of the removing, so what is the center of mass? So changing or shift of the center of mass, shift of center of mass due to removal of mass. Removal of mass. Whenever some mass is removed, how center of mass will be shifted. So this is very important concept. Let us consider one uniform body. Whenever if I told uniform body, center of mass will be located at a geometric center. Can I call it as C? From this uniform body, what I am doing is, some of the mass or some part is removing. I am removing some part. So this part is center of mass, let me call it as C. When I remove this part from this uniform body, so the center of mass of this remaining part will be there, it will be shifted. So away, it will be shifted away from the quarter, from the space where the mass is removed. Now I remove the mass from right side. Center of mass will be shifted towards left side. Okay, na? So let me call the total mass of the uniform body is capital M, and mass which is removed is small. So okay, na? So what is the total mass value will be equal to M, and the removed value is small. Now what is the mass of the removed part? Mass of removed part will be equal to, can I hear, we call it small m now. What is the mass of the remaining part? Mass of the remaining part. That remaining part mass value will be given by, so which is equal to, can I call the mass of the remaining part as m2 m1? That m1 value is equal to capital M minus small m. Correct only now? How I will calculate the mass of the remaining part? What is the total mass minus mass of the removed part? Will give you mass of the remaining part. I call this mass as M1. Now what is the mass of the removed part? This is of removed part. So that mass can I call M2. That M2 value is equal to small. Correct? Now I want to locate. So what I want to calculate is, what is the shift of the center of mass? Center of mass is shifted. So this value can I call X shifter. The shift value I want to calculate. So in order to calculate the shift value, first, what is the coordinates of the shifted? Now center of mass is shifted from C to C1. So x1 coordinate is given by x1 is equal to minus C1, which is given by x shifted. Can I write that? So what is this x shifter? That is the remaining part is there, na? That remaining part center of mass from the actual center of mass, from the original center of mass. So that coordinates are given by minus C into C1, which will be equal to x shifted. So this is the value of x1. Similarly, what is the value of x2 will be given there. What is the distance of the remote center of mass from the initial original center of mass? So that distance value, can I call it as d? So this distance is given by c into c2. This c into c2 value, can I write d? These points are clear. Now I want to locate the center of mass. To locate the center of mass, what is the formula? Xcm is equal to m1 into x1 plus m2 into x2 divided by how much? M1 plus m2. Here what we consider is, so What we will consider is M1 will consider it as the mass of the remaining part, and M2 will consider it as mass of the removed part. X1 is the X1 we will measure, that is the distance from which, through which the center of mass is shifted. And what about X2? That is the distance between the original body center of mass and center of mass of the removed part. This point should be clear. D value is what? Distance between C and C2. And one more important point is the center of mass of the initial body, the center of mass of the removed body, and center of mass of the after removing the mass. So all center of mass will lie in the same line only. Okay? Then x same value is equal to. Can I substitute the value sum? What is capital M? M1 value? Capital M minus small m. Into which one? So into I will get it as x shift. X shift. Can I take this x shift value as minus? So why can I take minus? It is, so if I take this as origin, so this will be left side of origin. That's why I will take it as minus. So minus m into plus. What is the removed mass value m into x1 value d divided by how much will get m1 value capital M minus small m. So plus m2 value will be 1 by m will be equal to x3. But initially, what is a uniform body? Whenever body is a uniform body, so where was the center of mass will be there? At origin. What are the coordinates of center of mass? 0 and 0. So that's why what I will get, this value should be equal to 0. 0 is equal to capital M minus small m into x minus of plus m into d divided by capital M L. Correct? Then after simplification, if I set this capital M beside, so what I will get answer? Capital M minus small m into x will be equal to m into d from this x is nothing but a shift, so x value will be equal to m into d divided by capital M minus small m. So this is the formula to calculate the shift of the center of mass. So that shift is given by, the shift of the center of mass is given by the formula m into d divided by m minus m. So what is m? M is the mass of removed part, mass removed into what is d? D is the distance between the center of the original body and the center of the removed body divided by what is capital M? So initial mass, original mass, original mass minus what about small m? Removed mass. Removed mass. Are you getting that? So that is the formula to calculate the shift of the center of mass. To calculate the shift of the center of mass, we need to know three things. So we need to know, so what is the initial mass of the body when mass is not removed? And what is the mass which is removed? And we need to know what is the distance between the centers of original body, center of mass, and so center of the removed body. This value is called as what? D. By knowing this, we can calculate the shift. This is the method for removing. For example, this is the method for adding. If I want, if some mass is added, same method will be there. Because of the adding, what happened to the center of mass will be shifted towards the region where mass is added. That time the formula everything is same, but in denominator what I will get is m into d divided by capital M plus 1. Are you getting that? Shift method is very very important. So in many cases we need to use calculation of this. Now we will see some applications based on this. So removal of mass. Okay now? So always remember, what is the formula for shift? Shift, x shift. So a center of mass shift will be equal to m into d divided by capital M minus small m. Okay, where m is the mass of the removed part, d is the distance between the center of original body and center of mass of the removed body, and capital M is the original mass of the body. Let us see the first application. In this first application, let me consider one circular plate. The circular plate of radius value capital R. From this circular plate of radius value capital R. So this radius value capital R. So what I did is a small circular plate of radius small r is removed. So this circular plate radius value small r is removed. okay na? Now what I want to calculate is shift of the center mass. So initially this is the center mass for this capital R radius. This is the radius of capital R and this is small. Now what I want to calculate is, so let us consider this is the total given circular disk, circular plane, and this is the remote circular plane. So center of mass will be shifted towards where? So away from the remote part. If initially this is the center of mass, so this will become final center. And this is the center of, so the remote part, that will be of C. C value, C1 value and C2 value. Now I want to calculate what is the distance by which it is shifted. To calculate the shift, what I need to know? I need to know the mass of the remote body and initial mass of the body. So let me consider mass per unit volume. Mass per unit volume. Unit volume is equal to rho. So that is nothing but our mass density. Rho value nothing but our, so it is also called as mass density, mass by volume. So that mass density value is called to rho. I consider the mass density to find out the mass of the initial sphere and remote sphere. So can I call the mass of the initial sphere is m1 and mass of the remote sphere is m2? Then what will get m1 value? Density is equal to mass by volume. So what will get mass is equal to density into volume. So what will get here m value is equal to? M value is equal to, so volume value given by, can I call first sphere mass is m1? First, not sphere here, first circular disk mass is m1. So m1 value given by, so pi into r1 square, can I call thickness value t? Volume is given by area into thickness, pi into r1 square into t, into which one now? Rho. Correct? Similarly, what is the mass of the remote part is given by, f2 value is equal to, but here I call the radius of this circular disk, initial circular disk is r1, r, capital R. Pi r square into t divided by remote part radius is 1 by pi into small r square into t into rho. Okay now? So m1 value calculated, m2 value calculated. M1 is here nothing but capital M. M1 is nothing but capital M. M2 is nothing but small. I know capital M value, small M value. Still, which value I want to know? I want to know the d value. So what is d value? Can I call c into c2 will be equal to t. Where d is the distance between what I got? Distance between the center of which one? Initial center of mass and center of the remote part. Then what is the shift is given by the formula? So x shift is given by the formula. So what is the mass of the remote part is given by pi into small r square into t into rho into separation between the two centers is given by d by, so pi into capital R square into t into rho minus pi into small r square into t into, then which one I can take common in numerator and denominator, which will be cancelled. Pi into rho value will be, pi into rho into t will be cancelled. Then what is left? R square into d divided by capital R square minus small r. So this is the formula for calculating the shift of the center of mass. Question understood now? What is small r? The radius of the remote circular disk. And what is capital R? The radius of the given circular disk. So small r square minus capital R. This is for the circular disk. Whenever from the circular disk of radius capital R, a small circular disk of radius small r is removed such that the center of mass distance of the initial body and the center of the remote body is d, then what is the shift formula? Is given by r square into d divided by, so r square minus small r. The same formula we can also derive for sphere. Instead of the circular disk, they given a sphere. If they given if it is a sphere, then what I need to write? Volume will become 4 by 3 into pi r. For the sphere, so how I calculated now for the circular disk? The same method we can calculate. What will get the formula for x shift is equal to r cube. R cube into d divided by capital R cube minus 1. Okay now? So this is for this one now, for circular disk. For circular disk, how to calculate the center of mass is, if it is given a sphere, so shift is given by the formula r cube into d divided by capital R cube minus small r. Are you getting that? So why here r cube? For the sphere, what I need to write the mass value? 4 by 3 into pi into capital R cube. Small here value, 4 by 3 into 5 into R2. That's why here I will get R2 by 20 divided by capital R2 minus 1. This is first application for calculation of shift of the center of mass. Let us see, like this many applications are there. And each and every application is very important. And each and every application can be also given directly as a question. So let us see one more application, second one, for calculation of this shift value. So let me consider one circular disc. This circular disc of radius value capital R. So let me consider here it is the initial center of mass. Center of mass of the given body. Now what I did is a small sphere is removed. A circular plate is removed, not sphere. Every time getting sphere, but it is not sphere. It is a, initially we will consider for circular disc. Similarly, we will apply the formula for sphere. So this side, a small circular disc of radius small r1. So this radius value, let me call it as small r. But remember, whenever you are writing, you should take care that center of mass of all the lies in the same thing. So now, how we remove the circular plate? A circular plate of radius small r, removed from the circular plate of radius value capital R, but from one edge. Now this time, what is the distance between the centers of, this is the initial center of mass. This is the center of mass of the removed part, C2. So what about this distance value will become? So that distance is given by D. Okay now? So in this case, what happened to D1 now? Can I write M1 value as it is? M1 value is equal to how much? So M1 value is equal to, M1 is the mass, capital M, mass of the given body. That is given by pi into R square into T into rho. What is the mass of the removed part, which is given by small m, will be equal to pi into R square into T into rho. So that is over. What is the distance between the two spheres are given by? So distance between the two spheres here is R minus R. Because of the removing the part out from the earth term. Now if I want to calculate the total distance, so actually here to here the distance value is equal to R. From this R, if I remove which one small r, I will get a D value. So D is equal to capital R minus small r. That time what I will get the formula for shift? So x shift is equal to, directly I will apply the same formula. What is the formula is given by? X shift is equal to same formula. R square into D, but D value R minus R, divided by. So denominator what I will get? R square minus R square. Instead of once again calculating, I am writing directly. Like how we written the last time for the circular disc, same I will apply, but except this. So here in place of D, what I written? R minus R. When I write R minus R, then what is the formula for x shift I will get is, so R square into R minus R divided by. So denominator can I write, that is of the form A plus B into A minus B. So A square minus B square. Can I write R square minus R square is written as R plus R into R minus R. Then what happens? R minus R cancel. So this time the shift will be maximum. The maximum shift is given by R square divided by R plus R. Whenever you want to get the maximum shift, so for the center of mass, the mass should be removed from where? Edge. Whenever mass is removed from the edge, the distance between which one, the centers of the original body and the center of mass of the removed body will be greater to provide the shift value maximum. The maximum shift is given by R square divided by R plus R. So this is whenever a circular plate of radius small r removed from the one edge of a circular plate of radius capital R, the shift of the center of mass. Where does the center of mass will be shifted out? It will be shifted out away from the region where mass is removed. Okay now, if the same formula you want to write for the sphere. For the sphere, what will it here we get a formula R2 into D divided by R2 minus R2. Can I substitute the value of D value? When I substitute the D value, so I will write here for the sphere. For sphere, so what I get the formula is x shifted. What is the general formula? Here sphere is in same. Considering the circular sphere of radius and small sphere of radius small r is removed from that, shift formula is given by R3 into D divided by R cube minus R, which can be written as, so x shift value is equal to how much? R cube into D value is given by R minus R by, so A cube minus B cube can be written as R minus R into R square plus capital R into small r. If you have any doubt, you check it. you multiply this r square plus r square plus r into r with r minus r, you will get r cube minus small r. So r minus r cancel. What is the formula for shift is given by? So shift is equal to r cube divided by. So r square plus capital R into small r. This is the formula to calculate a shift. Whenever from the sphere of radius capital R, a small sphere of radius small r is removed from the earth. So then what is the shift of the center of mass is given by the formula this. Okay now? So this is the second application for removal of mass. So third application is same diagram only. So in this third example we will consider first for circular disc. First we will consider for circular disc. We will apply the concept of if you want the first sphere. So in this circular disc this is the center one. You see. Then what I am doing is, so removing of mass. The removal mass is somewhat more. How I am removing the mass is, you see here. So this is the sphere which is circular disc which is removed. Okay, such that now this is the radius of this removed part. So in this diagram, see m1 value is equal to this one, m2 value is equal to this one. But what about the d value? In this diagram, what about the d value will be given? So d is equal to, what is d? This is the center of the original sphere, this is the center of the removed part c. So distance between these two, so d value will be equal to, so here d is equal to r, which is equal to capital R by 2, correct? Which is exactly half. You remove in a such a way that, so radius of which one now? Radius of the removed part will be equal to half of the radius of the given part. Understood? So where it is the midpoint, the center will be the midpoint for this. So diameter of the removed part will be equal to capital R only. The radius of the removed part will be equal to R. That time I want to calculate the shift. So what is the formula for shift? For a circular disc formula will be same. R square into d divided by capital R square minus small r square. But what about R square value, R by 2 whole square. Into d value also equal to R by 2. Divided by, so R square minus R value will be equal to R by 2 whole square, correct? Then whatever your numerator is given by, that is R square into R cube. Here 2 square 4, 4 into 2, 8. So 8 divided by denominator, whatever you get, this is R square minus, this is the value of R square by 4. So what is LCM here is 4. Then after simplification, whatever you get, that is of R cube by 8 into, can I say that this term to numerator, what will get 4 divided by how much I get LCM is 4, 4 R square minus R square, this is a 3 R square. So R square or R cube, so 1, then 4 1s are 4 2s are. So what is x shift is given by the formula, x shift value is equal to R divided by how much 6. Understood? Whenever from the circular disc of radius capital R, a small circular disc of radius small r, is removed from one edge such that that small r value is equal to r by 2. So that time directly you can write. Whenever the question is given, the numericals will come to know. If the question is given like this, instead of doing all this, directly you can remember x shift. One formula you have to remember. Whenever if I told you the circular disc, so formula for shift is r square into d divided by r square minus r. This formula will be constant. Only in this formula you need to substitute the values of d. The same method can be also calculated for sphere. Understood now? So if question topic understood properly means center of mass is very interesting topic. But the thing is, to getting only you need to pay more attention. After completion of this, second application is over. We'll see one more application. So that is our third application. In this third application, what I am considering is, I am considering one square plate. This square plate of length value, let me call it as 2L. Now I am dividing this square plate into 4 parts. Okay, so this is the, if it is uniform mass, this is the initial center of mass. Such is that, so one of the plate, one of the part, so 1/4 of the square plate is removed. Now, what if this is the center of removed part? Can I call it as C2? If total length value will be equal to 2L, then obviously this length value will be equal to L. If this length value will be equal to L, what happened to this distance? The distance value will be given by C2, C into C2. C2 will call it as D, where D is the distance between the original center of mass and the center of mass of the removed part. So that distance value, how can I calculate? So in this square, what about the diagonal value? If this is L, this is L. So this value will be of root 2 into L. Root 2 into L divided by how much of root 2? So what will get the answer? L by root. Correct? This value will be of L by root. Then what is the original mass value, M1? So mass value, M value is equal to kinetic from now onwards. Mass is equal to density into volume. Correct? Mass value is equal to whatever you get the answer. So density into volume. Here square is there. So M1 value will be given by M1 value is equal to. So L square into rho into T. Kinetic. What is M1? M1 is the mass of the original body. Original body mass directly also we can write. Mass value directly proportional to area. This thickness or this thickness, so everything is same. So mass volume, mass of the body directly proportional to area. As per that term, so what is the mass of the original body? M1. M1 directly proportional to area. So what is the area value? 2L whole square. That is given by 4 into L square. Correct? Similarly, what is M2? M2 value directly proportional to L square. So M2 value directly proportional to L square. Can I write up? M1 is the mass of the original square. M2 is the mass of the removed square. Then what is the formula for X shift? Shift formula will be given by how much? So M into D divided by which one? Capital M minus 1. Correct? So whatever the mass value removed one will be given by L square into D value will be given by L by root 2 by capital M value will be given by 4 L square minus L square. So what will get the answer? L cube divided by, so denominator what will get root 2 3 L, 4 L square minus L square. So that is the value of 3 L square into root 2. So L cube L square cancel. So what will get the answer? L divided by 3 into root. So this is the formula for X shift. Why I written here mass value? Since both are made up of the removed part and also the original part made up of same material. Density value same. Mass is equal to density into volume. Density value same, thickness value same. So that's why mass directly proportional to area. Then first mass is directly proportional to 2L whole square. That is 4L square. This is nothing but capital M. And this is nothing but small. Can I write up? No sir, I did not get. Means you can substitute individually. M1 value can be written as area into thickness into density. M2 value can be written as, so area into thickness into density. The thickness into density will be cancelled. That's why directly from now onwards, we will write in place of mass, so area value. Okay? Then the formula. This is how to calculate the shift of the center of mass from the square plate of side of 2L. So 1, if it is divided into 4 parts and 1 part is 0. Understood now? The next one is fourth application. Each and every application can be asked one question. When you go through numericals, so each and every application will be given it as one question actually. So one more application what I will consider is, I will consider one square plate. Square plate of length value of 2L. So from this, the one quadrant of the square plate, the remote one circular disc. Here the circular disc is completely occupied. Completely occupied by this 1/4 of the area. Are you getting it? From the square plate of side value 2L, a circular disc, it is divided into 4 parts. Such that, so one circular disc, the circular disc is removed from 1/4 of the square. Clear? So what about the circular disc radius value will be given by radius of the circular disc value. So this length value will be equal to L. The radius will be equal to L. Now, what is the initial center of mass? This is the center of mass of the original body. This is the center of mass of which one? The removed part. Can I call this value C2? What is the distance from C1 to C2? So this value will be given by C into C2. C2 value is equal to D, which is given by, actually this is a square part. This value will be equal to L, this value equal to L. And what will get the diagonal value? And one more important point is here, we are removing that circular plate. Circular disc, from that 1/4 of the quadrant, 1/4 of the square, in a such a way that maximum area, it is almost occupying the total area of this 1/4 of the square. Then C1 into C2 value will be equal to D. So what about the D value will be equal to? That is L by root. You can calculate now, diagonal value root to L. So that is L divided by root. The next one is, what is the capital M? Capital M is the original mass. Already I told you. Original mass now what not find, right? Directly as a square of the area. So 2L whole square. The 2L whole square value will be equal to 4 into L square. And what about the removed mass value given by? Removed mass value I want to calculate means, so I need to know what is the radius of this circular disc. Radius value will be equal to L by 2. So what I will get the area value? Pi into R square. R square value is equal to